I'm Sam.
And I'm Izzy.
And this is YSTV Society Scoop. Hello everybody, welcome to YSTV Society Scoop. I'm Sam, and today I'm joined by Samuel, who's from the Comedy Society, and he's the chair of the society. So, Samuel, how are you doing today?
I'm alright, mate, how are you?
Yeah, not too bad. How are you finding the lockdown?
Same as everyone else. It's flatlined, it's a plateau now, you know?
I can't blame you, honestly, I can't blame you. It's all been a bit... meh.
Yeah.
So, what would Comedy Soc normally be doing if it wasn't for the lockdown?
Well, usually we're a pretty active society. We have we would do weekly comedy shows, live comedy shows, every Wednesday in Vanbrugh. And those would range from sort of stand-up comedy to improvised comedy to sketch comedy, and then even like panel shows like Have I Got News For You and stuff like that. And those would be available for anyone to come and watch, whether you're a member or non-member. Members do get a discount, though. It'll be open to people to come and perform in, depending on the sort of format of the show. And we also would run free workshops for any university students. So those would also be workshops in stand-up comedy, improvised comedy, sketch writing and sketch acting. And like I said, they'll be free to attend, and it'll be just a great environment to sort of learn and get to know people. Is the main idea.
Wow, that's like a plethora of creativity right there. So, yeah, given the lockdown, how have you had to adapt as a result of like all this bad stuff?
Well, it's been pretty, it was pretty rough initially, because our like bread and butter was our live shows. And when we initially, in the first lockdown, when everyone was separated around the country, there was no sort of way we could do anything. So we've sort of adjusted to doing online formats for shows, and it wasn't such really as simple as just sort of moving to a Zoom room, because we found a lot of our stuff relied on like a live audience that you needed to bounce off of, and you didn't get the same thing over Zoom. So initially we created a podcast, the Comedy Soc podcast, which we put out an episode every week in the third term of last year, which then I think went on to win a Society Award, so for like the best digital response to COVID, so we're pretty proud of that. And now what we're doing is we've got the podcast back, but we're also running videos in between the podcasts. So it's sort of like a rotating weekly schedule of podcast content as well as video content, depending on what, you know, people prefer, because people might find it easier to watch a podcast than, or watch a video than a podcast. So, yeah.
Yeah, I'm glad that you're still offering like stuff despite all the... keeping home and whatnot, especially because it's comedy. That's like funny stuff right there. So with online activities becoming the norm, do you think that more activities down the line are going to become like open? Like, do you think you're going to start like creating new stuff?
I think so, because it's been a hard like way to adapt, but I think sort of the way things are going, we have to sort of be open to the idea of creating those sort of new ways that everyone can get involved in, because we were worried about people coming in new who hadn't been in the society before and how they would integrate naturally if you can't, you know, go to a pub after a show or something like that. And I think what we've been really trying to do is create formats that are different to what we were doing before, because we can't do the same thing as we were doing before, but it's still in the area of comedy and it's still really accessible for people to join in on. And I think every society sort of had to find a way to do that.
If I, let's say, wanted to create some sketches on my own or take part in any of the activities that you've mentioned today in this interview, how would I go about that, like, as a fresher?
Well, the best place would be, we are still running some of our workshops that we would have been running in normal times online. So we have a stand-up comedy workshop that we teach every Sunday, which is just for an hour where we sort of teach a lesson. And then if people want to go through some sets or some ideas, they can do that and get feedback from the group. It's a really safe environment to help people sort of learn. And those are Sundays at 1. There's a Facebook group, if you go to our Facebook page, where you'll get a link to join a Zoom call. And we also have sketch writing workshops every Saturday, I think 2 till 4, which is a writer's room sort of place where people can sort of write sketches and sort of get feedback on them too. And that seems to work really well online, because it's, some people find it easier to sort of join the call, but then sort of mute it and then write in their own time and then come back to everything. And on top of that, we also do have sketch acting workshops every now and then, less like frequently. So those are the best ways to come in and get to know people and join in. And then once you've you're comfortable with that, we post on our Facebook lots of opportunities where you can get involved. Like, we've just had auditions for Taskmaster, as we're doing a Taskmaster series, and we've got more of those sort of opportunities being posted about soon-ish. So that would be the best way to sort of get involved if you're interested.
Wow. Okay. Perfect. That is... Well, well done. Thank you for giving me so much information to work with. I'm pretty sure every fresher or any person within the university will be so appreciative that, you know what, if they want to make sketches or do anything comedy related, come to you guys. So, right, thank you for taking part in this interview. Thank you so much.
No worries, my pleasure, mate.
Thanks. Thanks for watching.
Make sure to follow us on all our social media for more YSTV's Society Scoop.